Ladies and gentlemen, we want to welcome you to tonight's very special Jim Nabors concert, produced by Bob Van Cleek of Pathway Tours, Chaplin Entertainment, and Barbara Pulchinski Management. Jim Nabors will be on this stage very shortly, but right now, we want to introduce you to the lady personally selected by Jim Nabors to open tonight's East Coast concert. Laura Roth has appeared on television, radio, in nightclubs, and on the stage. An amazingly versatile singer, actress, and impersonator, she has been reviewed by the New York Post as a showstopper, and Show Business newspaper referred to her as one of the world's leading cabaret singers. Laura has studied the work, mannerisms, and clothing styles of the greatest female entertainers of the 20th century, and she will become four of them before you tonight. Calling upon a large personal collection of vintage clothing, plus 125 costumes specifically designed for her stage productions by Joe Barron and Richard Baker, she performs year-round throughout the United States and feels honored to open for Jim Nabors here tonight before all of you. Connie Francis was born Concetta Franconero in Newark, New Jersey, and won first prize on Arthur Godfrey's Star Time Talent Scouts program when she was 12 years old, performing on that show for the next 4 years. Godfrey asked her to change her last name to Francis as he had difficulty pronouncing it. After being rejected by many record labels, she signed with MGM Records but had no hits. About to quit show business and study medicine, her father convinced her to record the 1930s song, Who's Sorry Now? Dick Clark introduced it on American Bandstand in 1958. It sold a million, and the rest is history, including movies such as Where the Boys Are and song hits such as Stupid Cupid, Lipstick on Your Collar, and many more. Incidentally, she recorded her country album backed by the Jordanaires, who have backed Jim Nabors as well. Beautiful and glamorous, she has been an audience favorite for decades. Proud to open for Jim Nabors, here is Connie Francis.
Sorry now. much. I'm sorry, I just get a little emotional. I'm sorry. Oh, thank you, dear. Thank you so much. I've had a terrible time with men, you see. Oh, thank you, dear. Thank you. Thank you. You can sit down now, okay, honey? Yes, sir. When you left me all alone at the record pub, told me you were going out for a soda pop. You woke up for quite a while, half an hour more. You came back and man, oh man, this is what I saw. What? Lipstick on your collar. Tried to tell me it was mine, made me stop and think. And then I realized yours was red, mine was baby pink. Who walked in but Mary Jane, lipstick all a mess. Were you smooching my best friend? I guess the answer's yes. Lipstick on your collar.
Here, take these. There you go. Okay, there you go. Hey, aim it at my eyes, will you please? I got two of those too. Walking down some street in town, and I know he's waiting there for me. In the world of a million people, I'll find my Valentine. Then I'll climb to the highest steeple. The day we're together once more. until the day that we're together.
Ladies and gentlemen, after each of Laura's numbers, a musical clue to her next diva will be played by the Laura Roth Quintet, featuring on percussion Rich LaPlante, on sax and flute Scott Larson, on bass Mike Caselli, on synthesizer and guitar Jonathan Newell, and on piano Laura's musical director, Catherine Elizabeth Reed. And a shout out on a special 46th wedding anniversary, Ray and Irma Dixon from Prescott, Ontario, Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, our next celebrity was born Margaret Carmen Cancino and began her show business career when she was only 6 years old. Her father was a successful Spanish dancer and her mother appeared in the Ziegfeld Follies. She signed with Columbia Studios and made 24 B films before her name was changed to Rita Hayworth. She hit the big time in 1946 when Columbia released Gilda, in which she appeared with Glenn Ford. With this role, she was the first Hollywood star to be designated a superstar by the New York Times. On the cover of Life and many other magazines, she was referred to as the love goddess of the world. In Gilda, she sang the song Put the Blame on Mame in two scenes. One a soft version with guitar, and the other as a devil-may-care dancer. Her voice was dubbed in both scenes, but in a black satin dress and black gloves, and with her long hair flowing, she simply oozed sexuality. Many of you may remember that Rita Hayworth later did a spoof of her Gilda character on The Carol Burnett Show. Jim Nabors was the guest star on Carol's premiere show, September 11, 1967, and he appeared on the show a number of times thereafter. From the glamorous past, here again is Rita Hayworth.
Sailor. Louie. Is that Mrs. Louie? Almost. It's a family show, Louie. You should be ashamed of yourself. When Mrs. O'Leary's cow kicked the lantern in Chicago town, they say that started the that burned Chicago down. Well, that's the story that went around, but here's the reason.
Chicago down. Put the blame on me, boys. Put the blame on me.
So how many years has it been, Louis, that you were almost Mrs. Louis? That many, huh? She doesn't even want to sit next to you anymore, Lou. When they had the blizzard back in Manhattan, 1906, they said that traffic was tied up and folks were in a fix. Well, that's the story that went around. But he's yellow down. Put the blame on me, boys. Put the blame on me. Maine gave a guy such an ice cold no. For 7 days they shoveled snow. When they had the gold rush, folks started running to California. They had plans of making $1 million a day. Well, that's the story that went around. The blame on Maine. Maine started the gold rush, it's my belief, by pulling gold out of some guy's teeth. Put the blame on Maine, boys. Put the blame on Maine. Put the blame on Maine, boys. Put the blame on Maine. You gotta put the blame.
Ladies and gentlemen, Laura Roth announces a surprise guest has just flown in from the West Coast. This is the first woman to win a Grammy for her recordings, an Oscar for her films, an Emmy for her television work, and a Tony for her Broadway performances. She describes herself as, quote, simple, complex, generous, selfish, unattractive, beautiful, lazy, and driven. Her name is Barbra Streisand. The brilliant Carol Burnett, Jim Nabor's dear friend, due to prior commitments, turned down the role of Fanny Bryce in Broadway's Funny Girl, the show that catapulted Barbara to stardom. Although she makes very few concert appearances, she called this morning and insisted on personally saluting Jim Nabor's at tonight's concert appearance. So here she is, ladies and gentlemen, Barbara Streisand.
People who need people are the luckiest people in the world. We're children needing other children, and yet letting a grown-up pray. Hide all the need inside, acting more like children than children. Very special people. They're the luckiest people in the world. With one person, one very special person, a feeling. A person who needs people. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Laura's final performance tonight is as one of the greatest entertainers of the 20th century. Born Frances Ethel Gumm in Minnesota in 1922, she worked in show business for 45 of her 47 years. She did 32 feature films, received a Special Academy Award, and was nominated for 2 others. She starred in 30 of her own television shows, garnering 10 Emmy nominations. Between 1951 and 1969, she performed over 1,100 theater, nightclub, and concert performances, winning a Tony Award for the first of 3 record-breaking Broadway performances at the Palace. She recorded nearly 100 singles and many record albums, and did so much more, including benefits, vaudeville, and radio. This is Laura Roth's most requested impersonation, particularly from those who saw the one and only Judy live. Here, ladies and gentlemen, is Judy Garland.
Beyond the
Ladies and gentlemen, Laura Roth.
Thank you, everybody. God bless you all. Thank you.
In just a few minutes, the fabulous Jim Nabors.